Good day to you parents and grade 2 learners. I hope you're all keeping well. Today for English, I would be revising the basic parts of speech which we're familiar with. The first part of speech is nouns. A noun is a naming word. A noun is the name of a person, place or thing. Example 1. Tom, Ben and Sam are in grade 2. You will see that Tom, Ben and Sam are highlighted in red. It tells us that they are names of people, so they have to start with a capital letter. Sentence 2. They attend Deccan Road Primary School. Deccan Road Primary School is the name of a school, so they all have to start with the capital letters. Sentence 3. Pam and Jack go to Checkers on Friday. Pam and Jack are names of people. They start with capital letters. Checkers is the name of a store, and Friday is the name of a days of the week. Henry lives in Loop Street. Henry is the name of a person, and Loop Street is the name of a street. Sentence 5. Dad bought a Toyota Corolla on Wednesday. Toyota Corolla is the make of a car, and Wednesday is the days of the week. Our second part of speech is verbs. A verb is a doing or an action word. Example 1. The baby sits and eats her porridge. Sits and eats will tell us what the baby is doing. Sentence 2. Uncle Bob drives his new car. What does Uncle Bob do? He drives his new car. Sentence 3. Tabo digs and plants in the garden. What does Tabo do? He digs and plants. So those are the action words. The last sentence, Granny visits us on Sunday. Visits tells us what Granny does on a Sunday. So those are your verbs. The third part of speech is adjectives. An adjective is a describing word. It tells us more about a noun. Example 1. The cute baby is happy. Cute describes the baby. Sentence 2. We saw the funny clown at the circus. What kind of clown did we see? A funny clown. Sentence 3. Jimmy is a naughty boy in our class. The word naughty describes Jimmy. Sentence 4. Pamela brings delicious lunch and healthy fruit to school. Delicious describes the lunch, and healthy describes the fruit. Sentence 5. I read an interesting story book. What kind of a book do I read? Interesting. Our next part of speech is pronouns. A pronoun takes the place of a noun. Example 1. I eat my apple. Sentence 2. You read your book. Sentence 3. She colors in her picture. Sentence 4. He climbs up his tree. Sentence 5. We do our work at home. Sentence 6. They buy their groceries. The fifth part of speech is conjunctions. A conjunction joins a group of words or two sentences. Example 1. I sit at my desk. I read my book. Join these two sentences. I sit at my desk and I read my book. Sentence 2. We buy fish. We buy chips from the shop. We buy fish and chips from the shop. Sentence 3. Johnny went to the doctor. He was sick. Johnny went to the doctor because he was sick. Sentence 4. Megan wore her raincoat. It was raining. Megan wore her raincoat because it was raining. Sentence 5. Sheila was sick. She came to school. Although Sheila was sick, she came to school. Sentence 6. Mum drove the car. There was very little petrol. Mum drove the car, but there was very little petrol. You will find in a conjunction, when you're joining two sentences, there's only one full stop at the end of the last sentence. There's no full stop in the middle of sentences. The last part of speech is prepositions. A preposition shows the relationship of a noun or a pronoun to some other word in a sentence. Example 1. The vase is on the table. Where is the vase? On. Sentence 2. The dog sits under the chair. Where does the dog sit? Under the chair. Sentence 3. We walk across the busy street. Where do we walk? Across. Sentence 4. Jack tossed the ball over the net. It tells us where Jack tossed the ball. He tossed it over the net. Sentence 5. The rain came in through the broken window. How did the rain come in? Through the broken window. The last one. The tasty food is in the big pot. Where is the tasty food? In the big pot. I hope you've enjoyed the lesson. Thank you.